that like Sonic can go off stage in this game.
Absolutely.
And he can just spring Krom, and that's like maybe a stock.
Yeah. So maybe Roy, maybe Ike. Ike, I feel like it is, you know, either it goes even or wins this matchup. Yeah. So we are going to see the Ike. His Nair is just stupid good. That's all I can say. Like, I did 4 to 5 Nairs in a row with the platforms there.
And Goof is going Inkling.
Yeah, I forgot. Goof does have an Inkling. She does have an Inkling. So in this matchup, I feel like once you get the lead, you want to go on Triplast and just try and camp Inkling out. That's really.
And you were talking about Ike's Nair, and that can actually reach below. We've seen a lot of people complain about Inkling's like low profile mobility, but that Nair will catch it pretty well.
Mm-hmm. And again, okay, so Ike can get away with jumping a lot because now they improved frame 3 jump spot. But at the same time, you don't always have to jump. I feel like you still have to play like relatively honest with Ike, even though you can use Nair. But respect the ground game and just chip in when you can. Another thing to note is his grab range is a little bit shorter, so you kind of have to be really close to get any sort of grab. Nice Nair, you know, it is going to catch behind mid-jump.
But this disjoint zoning is doing very well for Maloney right now.
Yeah, and Maloney is jumping a lot. I like to see Goof try to capitalize on that because, you know, again, you don't always have to jump. So, nice forward air. And in this matchup, Inkling kind of just wants to like zone Ike and pressure him to a corner. So he can't kind of like abuse the Nair and like get it into like forward air, or if they get if it's like sends them behind, get a back air. Back throw, good option.
Back throw, get him off stage, but the recover high.
Yeah. Goof, she did have the right idea, just didn't quite time it correctly. That unsafe fair, but there could be no punish for it. And right now, what, you know, typically most Ikes would be looking for right now is kind of like weak hit of like Nair into up air, and that would reliably connect. She is out of the percent range for like down throw into like up air. You know, you can do it at certain percents. Nice mix up on the recovery.
But straight hits from Ike will kill. And higher percentages.
Yeah.
Higher percentage.
And it is a little bit harder to connect back here on shorter-ish characters in this game. It is still really strong, but
he was trying to get that up air you were talking about.
It is so good because you can like short hop fast fall it, and it's really good. But the F tilt, good option. You know, you really don't see really didn't see Maloney using anything. That was the first time I want to say that he used it. So
caught Goof just moving around.
Yeah. And see, okay, so that double up air was true. That third up air in a row, not
the Aether.
So I think he was probably expecting the Nair to connect and then probably do it into Aether. That down throw into up air was true because Goof, she did DI in, like in and toward Ike, so that is going to, that will allow you to cover connect with up air. And since it's like Korin's up air now from Smash 4, and not the helicopter, that is a true option.
And one thing we're not seeing much from Goof right now is because is the roller, and it's because Maloney is just using these platforms to run away, basically just sniping that option away from her.
That's what you want to do.
And we hear a lot of people complain about the roller, and here's the counterplay right
and
right
see,
here.
There's the Nair to up air I was talking about. Just it's bread and butter. See, that's the thing. With Rage, Ike, it is really scary to approach him. Nice tech chase. I would have preferred to see a grab, because you are limited in where you can go. So even if you do miss the grab and she rolls behind you, nothing of it, you can just do short hop like Nair. And there's that double Nair again.
That Nair covers half the stage.
It covers a lot of options. It covers behind you too, so if you're not spaced correctly and don't shield in time, or don't try and parry it at the very least, you can generally get away with it.
And we see a lot of platform camping here from Maloney, and it's working because you don't have the threat of roller, and Goof has to commit to an aerial in order to hit him.
And this is a really good counter pick to kind of Goof's playstyle inherently, I feel like.
Back throw?
Yeah.
That's not going to do it yet.
Yeah, yeah.
And the recover high option.
Yeah, that
because Inkling doesn't have the disjoints as and their aerials as Ike does. So even if they try to hit it, it might be futile. Are they stopping?
No, they're just.
They're just fooling around.
Or yeah, you can kind of. Maloney just trying to take a breath, you know.
Maloney. Maloney just letting Goof charge up, and the F2 will do it, and that's a 3-star from Maloney.
That was good. If I'm Goof, I try to play a little bit more aggressive, because that's where I feel like Ike is a little bit more oppressed, is where he can't zone break as easy. You saw Goof, I mean, you know, that is a good really play style to kind of play patient in the zone, but once Maloney got the first stock and just reached the platforms, you know, Goof really couldn't get anything going, like very, very solid strings. So if I'm Maloney, I'm banning any kind of like sort of like flat-ish stages in close quarters.
You want stages that have ideal platforms for you to run away to.
Yes.
You only have two bans, so Kalos might be the pick right now.
Yeah, I don't know if they did the hazards off further.
Is Goof going the Sonic?
Bye.
It's going to be a risky pick, but the Inkling didn't look so hot.
Gushi. Do they have hazards off?
We'll see.
Yeah. Okay. I hope they do, but anyways.
Be unfortunate if Pillars of Flame came out in the middle of the set.
that would be a little bit sad. Oh, fast fall. Okay, thank God that doesn't have the same end lag as it does in Brawl, or he was just dead there. Okay, so that was a good option, but forward air probably would have been better because it reaches more for the DIOA, and Goof would have had to mash air dodge to try and avoid it. And again, see, there's the jump. That's just that jump habit that's going on. Goof needs to try and figure out how to deal with.
And we see here that Maloney is just running to that platform.
See, like I told you, that's what you want to do in this matchup.
He's completely okay just waiting on platforms and then hitting her whenever it's possible.
Yeah. And see, like, you know, people might say, like, oh, that's so lame, but, like, I mean, like, if you're trying to win and you're trying to play the matchup correctly, that's what you gotta do. Like, sorry, not sorry, you know, that's all I gotta say for that.
Yeah, I'm just saying that Pitfall has a lot of, it's pretty good. The side B.
See, there's like the Nair to fair. It is a little bit easier to connect now in this game than it was in Smash 4.
The absence of a top platform is definitely giving Maloney less options to run to.
Mm-hmm.
And Goof is noticing this and just chasing him to the side platforms. They're pretty far apart.
Yeah, I was gonna say this. It is pretty like distance. And now for the first time we see like a Goof gaining a quite considerable lead. And but nice jab. Kind of just like snuff her approach option. But now here's again, like, now you want to play that patient game, and this is where Goof, she typically thrives on that.
I wonder what Maloney banned, because you would ban, like, FD, right?
I would probably ban FD.
And then what would the second ban be? Because you have two bans. This would probably be, in my opinion, the ideal second ban.
Yeah, maybe Smashville. And where's the other option? Oh. Yeah, see, I mean, that is... I don't feel it's that hard to get on Inkling. It's kind of like, you know, you can kind of anticipate it because there's only so many different options she can go, and she was already so low that she was trying to like drift and try and wait out eruption, but that's okay.
And here we're seeing Maloney playing a lot more aggressive, being forced to because he lost the player suddenly versus Inkling.
Yeah, and see, that's where I can really do kind of good is like, now that he has improved like jump spot and everything, is capitalize at the ledge and force options, but we are going to see Ike get the first stock again. Nice Nair to jab. You can do that because if you get the weak hit, it doesn't send them away far enough where you can kind of directional air dodge out of it in time, and the jabs link into each other. Again, nice Nair fair, just bread and butter.
And with the stock lead, we can see Maloney now being able to play a lot more passively, mm-hmm. but he's just going in right now.
Mm-hmm. And
trying to get this lead.
Goof kind of playing scared, you know, and I mean, again, you know, Rage, I feel like a lot of people would be scared, because like, what do you do? But she has to figure out some way to try and capitalize on that jump habit. We're gonna see the
back throw's not gonna do it. It's not gonna do it for a while. The stage has huge blast zones.
Mm-hmm. Yep, that was the near up air. She kind of DI'd in, so the up air was good, and it was a little risky too, because Maloney got the kind of like a strong hit of it, like the middle part of the sword.
And the up smash, that's not gonna do it either.
Yeah, Ike's heavy, man. Like, I think he was like low heavy, and rising up air again, a really good option. You know, he wasn't really using any like get up attack options like that, like jump get up. The fair
on the platform. Using the platform. The platform itself is a bit of a stage hazard. It's hazardous to be on there because they can just pressure you and then you're off stage if you get hit.
And we might see the free stock. That was a really good option. It was a good mix-up.
Ike at 200%.
Yes.
Goof is again.
We even got the We Like Ike chance. Kind of powering Malone up. Up smash, that's still not going to kill. Yep.
Still not going to kill.
No rage, but Ike's still heavy again. And like you said, man, the blast zones on the stage might be bigger. So that might be aiding in his option.
And we're back on the platforms again.
Yeah, again, like, why approach when you don't have to?
And just getting these bread and butter hit confirms off of aerials.
And sending him
the bombs are not killing.
That was a good shield. Up throw.
Back throw.
Back throw.
Mix up the DI.
Oh yeah, I forgot. Up throw is not that good for killing. Back throw finally is a good kill, but like I think he was at like 250, 260, I want to say.
Fourth throw doesn't kill either, right?
It can, but I don't know if it would have, honestly. So now quite a mountain for Goof to come back from.
There is the option to get Ike off stage, but you would have to keep the Aether, and that will do it.
Oh no, I'm sorry.
That's
it won't,
not,
yeah, yeah.
That won't do it.
I felt like I preemptively said that because of that new animation they do, but
it fools everyone, man.
Yeah, normally that wouldn't have killed because like Ike doesn't have enough rage for the up air to kill, and it is a little bit stale now. Here's the I don't know why she went that low. Ike wasn't. He wasn't like kind of like fast falling to recover that recover with eruption or excuse me with Aether. So
and there's another
yep.
one.
And you're going to see a two stock and a good game.
Very good counter play from Maloney. And that was very a dominant performance
and,
from him.
Now, again, I guess you'd be another favorite match I'd like to see. We're going to see Kesa versus Zenodo. Kesa, as soon as I mentioned, he said, sit down, boy, to Zenodo. You know, these guys go back to the Brawl days. So I am really, really, really excited to see this being able to commentate this.
I wonder if Zeno will go Diddy all the way because he's been talking up that Peach lately.
Yeah, dude, he said he really wants to go as Peach. Dude, Peach looks nuts, man. Like we've seen what Sam, aka Sam Sora, can do. So I wonder what Zeno does.